So there we are. Finally got to the top of Snowdon. And in this, I'm on my way down. You can see the cairn, or the plaque, at the top there, where I was able to be at the top and look all around. I'd be able to look down at the lake and such and take a few pictures. I did stay at the railway station at the top for just a little bit there. I was really wiped out and needed a drink and some chips, so I had something at the top of the mountain and tried to get a hold of a few people, but it wasn't working. There was no reception up there. The only way to connect, I guess, is to go down back on the train. But with the Snowdon railway system, you have to have a ticket coming up if you want to go back down. Right now, we have a sheep on the tracks, and they're honking at him to get him off of there so they don't run him over. So, watch the train, wave at a few people, take a few pictures, and then tried to head on down the mountain as quickly as I could. I think about this time it was 4:30, 5 o'clock, something like that. There's one of the plaques that shows you which way to go. If I had taken the one direction to the right, as we're walking right now, that would have been where I would have come up from the miner's path quite some time ago, in the early in the morning. But as it was, I went to a certain point, turned around, and you saw all of what I did. Tried to spend some time to be up there and enjoy the view. The weather turned out to be pretty good. You never quite knew, looking at the weather up around Snowdon, if it was going to be misty and foggy or whatnot. But the time that I was up there was pretty good. So I thought I would just point out something here, and that is you can see the path going up to the top of Snowdon with the railway station, but to the left, that's the colorless mountain, the mountain that I had a lot of trouble going over, and then coming up the backside of Mount Snowdon that you can't quite see, except in the second picture here, where people are on the walk-ins path, and they're gonna follow that left white trail, but somehow I missed it, and I pretty much went straight up, where you can sort of see another trail.
Hello, you got home, that tree calling you. Did you notice subs calling you at all? Yeah, I'm fine. Just took a little longer than I thought. Yeah. Well, I'm coming down off of Snowdon now. So, yeah. I was. I'm about like half hour from the top now. So, yeah, so, I hope not, I don't know, it looks like the city's a little distance away, but, yeah, I don't know how long, really, Dad, because I've never walked the walk, so, thank you.
I'd like to apologize for all the shaking here too. Obviously the action cam had trouble trying to keep up with my severe shaking. I was trying to hurry back down the Llanberis path, and as you can tell by some of the footage, it's not exactly smooth sailing. There's a lot of rocks and other debris that's in the way, and so I tried to do my best, but occasionally I did try walking on the grass as well, and that almost worked out. But with the grass, you couldn't tell if there was a divot or a hole in the ground, and it was just tall grass, so occasionally you'd step in something a little too deep, you'd have problems again. So I just wanted to apologize for the shake, rattle, and roll.
Thank you.
So we're coming to the end, and we're at the end of the Llanberis path. And fortunately, I had some good people waiting there for me for a while. I didn't know when I was coming back down, but I finally managed to make it. And I would just like to say thank you for being there. I appreciate you waiting and waiting and waiting for me. So this is at the end of the footage and of the walk on Snowdon, so you have an idea what it was like there. But I did add on a little bit after this to give you a different perspective of what the whole walk was like.